Hello everybody, my name is Jarl Chris, and welcome back to Let's Play Skyrim Anniversary Edition. In the last video, we were doing the quest of Bones for a Crow, and now we have to, continue on with this quest and travel to Arkwind Point, which is where? Over here. Okay, that's why I'm in Ivarstead, not Rorikstead. Yeah, so that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna hop on our little reindeer over here and march our way on over. Before we get too far into the video, I would like to say if you guys are enjoying the video or the series, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. It helps the channel grow, which we have been doing quite well lately, and I really appreciate it. Also, leaving any comments also helps. I really appreciate those too. I love responding to the comments and reading them. So, yeah. With all of that out of the way, let's get into this. Should we explore the cave? That is the important question to ask here. I say yes. Honey Strand Cave. It sounds like there's probably going to be bears in here, because, like, honey, bears. And, wow, wouldn't you know it? I'm so smart. Oh, there's two. Oh, Jesus. Come on, bear. You can do better than that. Where did I get the 100 gold from? That's very strange. Ooh, we only need 3 more bear pelts for Temba Wide Arms. I have no idea where that gold came from, by the way. We do have a level up, though. Okay, is that it for the cave? I believe so. I wonder if you can, like, see this from the outside. I mean, it's right over the cave, so the exit's right there. We're gonna do a little Skyrim science, guys. And I would like to thank anybody who watched the stream yesterday. Well, technically, I'm recording this on a Monday, so yesterday's Sunday, but this video is going up on Tuesday, so yesterday's now Monday. And I'm streaming Monday night at... Oh my god, there's another bear attacking my reindeer. So, yesterday is technically Monday night, and Monday night I'm streaming at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. But that means tonight I'm streaming at 8 p.m. Standard Time. But that doesn't help you understand, although it is going to be in the description, just my Twitch channel. I will be streaming on Sunday nights, probably Monday nights usually. Okay, what we're doing, there was that right there, and we are looking for a hole in the ground, which does not exist, apparently. There's a book over here, and I need to level up. So yes, that hole in the ground does not exist. Is this unique just hide armor? Okay, let's use that level up. We are now a level 21. That's insane. 200 health. Also insane. Can't get that. Can't get that because it's not going to help us. Like, I could get it, but it's not going to help. Let's see what we can do here. That's the 100. That's not going to help us. Dual wielding, nope. So it seems like we're pretty much maxed out in one-handed until we get the other things upgraded. I guess I could just throw it in the speech. Basically maxed out in one-handed until I get the more percentage of attack damage, because I am just using maces. There's another bear, holy crap. And yeah, basically, so like I was saying with the streams, I just want to stream every day that I don't work, which is Sundays and Mondays and every other Saturday. Obviously, there's going to be some days where I miss streams. But if there is a stream, it's probably going to be from 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to probably 9 to 10. Somewhere between those two times. And yeah, if you're ever available, I'd love to see you. I'd love to see the follow or something. It's all very appreciated. I'd love to grow that side more now that I can do it. Alchemist Shack, right? Yes. Hold on, guys. My left ear's itchy. Okay, that's better. What's in here? Butterfly in a jar. Did I get I'm at 9 pelts, right? Yes, so one more bear, and we can also finish that quest. What's this over here? Alchemist Journal. Notes on Tamed Rabbit. Started Pets of Skyrim. 14th of Second Seed. The rabbits here seem particularly adept at sniffing out potions ingredients. I recently found one nibbling on my thistle plants and managed to capture it. It is my hope that I will be able to train it to lead me to some of the most bountiful flora. 22nd of Second Seed. The rabbit, which I have decided to name Thistle, in honor of the carefully cultivated plants it managed to destroy, is showing great promise. It has proven to be quite tame and even rather intelligent. Getting it to respond to commands, however, can be a bit of a trial. I've resorted to plying it with carrots. Interesting enough, although I do not wish to have a rabbit named Thistle chasing me around, but we will remember that Thistle is here in case I ever decide to. Alchemist Journal. Coming to this area was a brilliant decision. The local flora seems to have many useful properties that I've been able to utilize into new potions. Outside, the rich soil has allowed the cuttings I've collected to grow into fine and bountiful plants. This afternoon, I think I will journey out for more mushrooms as my current supply is beginning to dwindle. On a personal note, I have moved my alchemy work outside of the shack. I find the midday air is a boon to my health as well as inspirational to my work. Also interesting. Nice little shack. But it's time we moved on from it. Okay, so the path to Arkwind Point should be on the left here pretty soon. Right? I think it's gonna be like here, probably, and up like this, or was it all the way back here? I'm not really sure. We can't just force our way up. You know what? Yeah, I'll just go up right here. Make it work. Maybe. I hear a dragon. Oh! Yeah, he's right there. Okay. I don't think this is working. Okay, never mind. It's working a little. We just got stuck. Now, let's hope this dragon doesn't, like, knock us off the mountain. That would be quite inconvenient, and it would kind of irritate me a little. Okay, dude, chill out. Okay, I believe that's Arkwind Point right there, so we're making good progress. Oh my god, there's something conjured up there now. I believe that was a flame atronach. Okay, dude. Can you not? Am I gonna be able to do this? I don't know. This definitely isn't the way I'm supposed to be going. I'm gonna fall. Yep. Where is the path, then? I mean, I obviously understand that this isn't the path, and I'm probably nowhere near it, but... Okay, it's starting to get there. It seems like they're fighting the dragon, whoever it is over there. So maybe they can take the heat off me while I'm trying to scale the cliff. Okay, never mind. The heat is all on me. Is there... serious? Oh my god, a blood dragon and a normal dragon. This is not good for us. Okay, luckily we've made it over. What? Okay, you know what? In here. Oh, it's this... What is happening right now? There is too many things going on all at once. Oh my god. There's a Draugr Deathlord here. Death Overlord, not just a Deathlord. I need to use some potions as well. Because my health is very low. I'm just going to use all of the poisons. Oh, I mean potions. I'll also poison him. Man, I really don't have many healing potions. Okay, now I should be super buffed. Oh my god. Does some serious damage. Is that just a Forsworn right there? We are in the rift right now. Why are you yelling about the reach? Oh, hey, dragon. You know what? This would make a killer thumbnail, so I'm gonna save right here. Hey, that's not nice. Let's just hide in here for a second. This is just a crazy battle right now. Oh, hey, normal dragon. Why are none of my hits connecting? Okay, there we go. I guess it was a little unnecessary shouting that dragon's body. Okay. Hello up there. This is crazy. Let's recharge Sunder. Come on, get down here, man. Yes. You know, this would be a good time to use, like, dragon skin. I mean, it's a little late in the battle, but it's something I probably should have thought of ahead of time. Okay, two dragons down, and a few Forsworn to go, I think. Apparently, this is a Restless Draugr. Okay, this person's name is Crow's Tooth. They're pretty powerful, actually. They did quite a bit of damage to me. Tyrant's Bane. Burns the target for 30 points. Targets on fire take extra damage. You know what, I never even searched that Draugr Deathlord. Who had an ebony war axe, mind you. Okay, yes, I traveled to Arkwind Point. Now what? Search the tower. Okay, what's up here then? Anything? There's a big chest. Steel plate helmet, I'm not wearing a helmet, actually. Ooh, what's all this over here? Just soul gem fragments and a sleeping roll. Wow, Bjormin Windstrider. Oh my god. Dragon bone mail heavy armor. Wow. Oh, this is a killer set of armor. I mean, except for these gauntlets, which don't really do... I mean, what am I wearing right now? I'm wearing silver armor, and this stuff isn't really all that much more powerful than it. I mean, it's still really good, but... not as powerful as I thought it would be. Bjorman's diary as well. Hold on, hold on. Let me drop this armor. Okay, let's read your journal. Or diary. How long is it? Okay, it's actually pretty long. Remember the first time Ashara showed me the tunnel, the one we had been burrowing for months. At first, I didn't understand it. We were already making good coins sacking the carriages. What was the point of digging holes underground like vermin? It didn't help that the tunnel smelled like a troll's armpit. We reached the warehouse and walked by crates stacked upon crates like mountains of wood. Mashara led me to the back where a dozen legionaries were unloading cargo too big for any box. In Shore's breath, I couldn't believe my eyes when I saw it. It was a skull, the size of a carriage, with fangs that touched the floor. For someone who winces at the sight of cliff racers, the idea of this monstrosity soaring through the sky made my heart tremble. And yet, for the first time, I felt alive. Okay, winces at the sight of cliff racers. Didn't St. Jib exterminate the cliff racers way back in, like, Morrowind time? Or, like, post-Morrowind, before Oblivion, right? In between that area? This is a Nord. They don't live that long. Would he have ever seen a cliff racer? That's a good question. So, plot hole. For what better way to live life than to fight a dragon? What better way to die? Now, that would be a story even Soon would lend an ear to. You think the bones are special. You should see what this one found yesterday, Mashara said to me. Her grin was as wide as the halls of Yorvaskar as she beckoned me further into the warehouse. Inside a crate set apart from the others was a cuirass of dragon bone mail. Mashara bade me to put it on, and I couldn't help but notice it was a perfect fit. In that moment, I thought of my Da. People called him a pirate, a murderer, and a thief. But he told me the Windstriders descended from the Dragon Guard, ancient warriors who fashioned armor from the bones of the dragons they slew. Still, my pride as a Nord wouldn't allow it. How could I face Soon wearing the armor of another's triumph? I could have the orc forged gauntlets and boots from the skull, but the curious. That which held one's heart must be earned in battle. My mind drifted then to stories I heard as a youngling of my great ancestor who strode through fire like it was the wind, wearing an ancient curious made of dragon bone. It was then that I knew my destiny. In his honor, I would claim it and fight until the day I reached Sovngarde. It's that same spirit that resides in me now. The others may be fine living in hiding, but a Nord is at war so long as he holds breath. Okay. Interesting little backstory. Although I did find the plot hole in it, so. That's something. Withershins, the book. I think I have to leave this here. I think this is for some, like, this location's actually for a, what is it called? College of Winterhold quest, right? The rest, like, the master of magic or whatever. Oh, yeah, now we have this dragonbone mail armor. It is quite powerful. Apparently. Dragonbone mail increases fire resistance 100%, so apparently we have 100% fire resistance. Carrying capacity is increased by 40 points, two-handed attacks do 30% more damage, and increases your health by 50. You know, this doesn't really help me because I use one-handed weapons, but oh well. And it's interesting that I got attacked by two dragons here when it's talking about all this dragon bone armor and stuff like that. Falmer arrows. Why is there Falmer arrows here? That's strange. Ebony War Axe can sell that for quite a pretty penny. So does this trap go... oh, yep. Here is Arkwind Point, the actual location. So, we'll clear this place out as well, and then probably finish... ooh, maybe we'll go up to the... other dragon there. There is a ward wall, too. Or maybe we are... you son of a... stop doing that crap. You're a white lord. You're not a death lord. You shouldn't be able to shout. Where did my Sunder go? There it is. I'm going the wrong way, aren't I? Yes. Okay, now that I have that back, I can go up and claim this word wall. Stamina, drain, vitality, not a very useful shout. Although, not very many shouts are actually that useful unless you, like, use them in the right situation. What's this? I think this over here is for another Creation Club thing. Yes, it is. I'm not going to enter in there because we will eventually have to come here. Hello? It's like an army of yeah, it is an army of skeletons. Okay, they just all got staggered. Wish I had like a sweeping attack. I could have taken out 5 of them at once. I love how weak skeletons are. You just cut through them like butter. Okay, who are you? Draugr Scourge. Nobody important. Okay. To the dragon place. Probably be another word of power. Maybe a third dragon for the video. 3 dragons, 1 YouTube video. Uh-oh. I see 2 ice wraiths down there. Okay, stop jumping, dude. It's so annoying. Okay, ice wraiths are way more difficult than I would think. Luckily, we have 50 more health. And we do fire damage, so. What's in here? Can I please get in? Nord, wearing nothing but a necklace. Well, also, the ragged clothes, but, yeah. How do I get to this dragon wall? I'm gonna make a quick save. Hello. Oh, it's this location. See if I can sneak up on this guy. Even though I have no sneak. Wearing heavy armor. What shout is this? Word of power learned. Kill, marked for death. Another not great shout. I mean, that one's pretty good if you're playing a certain type of character. Okay, I don't know why I grabbed that mace. It's quite useless to me. Two can play at that game, Mr. Dragon. Let's get out into the open where I can actually fight you. Where are you going to land up there? There's a floating bucket. That's cool. Okay, dragon, face me like a man. That's not what I meant. You're a loser. Ooh, blacksmith's filter. Hello. Some bedrolls here. Another skill book, although I've already read this one apparently. There you go. You're a big boy now. I'm literally wearing the bones and hides of your family. Do you really think you stand a chance? I just killed... He just flew right through this thing. Oh, he's coming in for a crash landing down there. Ooh. Am I gonna die if I do this? No. Okay. You know, I remember seeing this glitch before. I can't remember if I was playing it myself or if I was watching somebody play it. But they had this dragon, but he was just invisible. Okay, and you are smited, so that is three dragons. One video, we got some insane good armor. And yeah, how long? 25 minutes, this is definitely going to be where I wrap it up. I do hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure, leave a like and subscribe. I really appreciate it. Like I said again, I really hope you enjoyed it. And see you in the next one. Goodbye.